Hello and welcome to the student tutorial on shooting 3D objects to a target position by trajectory motion under gravity using rigid body velocity. For the demo purposes, we are using mouse press position in mouse space as target position, and the 3D object flies towards that position as the highest height into the trajectory path while affected by the gravity. The gravity is what bends the object's trajectory from linear to towards the ground. With velocity set to a constant value with no drag, the thrown object would follow a linear path if there is no gravitational force applied to it. This way of shooting was applied in a previous video that will be linked in the description. In this one, we will also apply gravity to the object and have a ballistic trajectory for the thrown object and make it move towards the target position by calculating the velocity for the movement. This is the fifth video recorded with this setting. The previous ones include implementation of shooting the object towards the target and helper approaches. All the models you see are from KayKit minigame variety pack, which will be linked in the description. If you are content with only calculating velocity for a target position in 3D for the ballistic motion, you can continue watching this tutorial. If you also would like to know how to set up the current setting, you can check out the previous videos explaining it. But to understand how to shoot a game object under gravitational force to a target position in 3D space, this tutorial should be sufficient. So let's start without further ado. This implementation has three components: spawn object that is spawned by the spawner, and shoot by spawn shooter. Spawn shooter decides when to shoot the spawn and with what approach. Spawn gets shoot by the commands taken from the spawn shooter. In this implementation, we are shooting the spawn object with gravity, so in spawn shooter's shoot function, we call shoot with gravity with the information of the target position, which is mouse position calculated for world space. In shoot with gravity, the velocity of the object is calculated so that it will pass through the target position. This velocity information is given to the reference of the current spawn object in current spawn that move with velocity and gravity function call. What move with velocity and gravity does is, it sets the input velocity vector to the velocity vector of the game object's rigid body and sets the gravity effect to be applied by setting use gravity to true, which at the start of the spawning is false at default. This way the object start moving with this velocity vector with gravity applied when it is shoot or thrown, however you call it. Now let's see how we calculate the velocity vector of gravity affected movement. As with any previous physics related movement tutorial, I used equations from hyperphysics, which will be linked in the description. So here we have two initial pieces of information: position of the object from object reference, current spawn that transformed position, which is the start position of the movement, and the final position of the movement, target pose. Using those, we calculate distance vector by subtracting the start point from the end point. Using a vector, we have distance changes for each axis separately to ease making calculations for separate axes. The max height the object will travel is the distance on the y-axis, so we are setting the y-value of distance to height. The range is the distance that will be traveled in the ground if the object will finish its full movement. In our case, the ground movement is cut half with the maximum height, that is why it is called half range. This stores half range for both x and z axis. That is why it is a vector that is created by the corresponding values from the distance vector. There is no drag in our movement, so each velocity is actually the initial velocity, like y0, x, yz. Using the equation of peak height, we first calculate the y component of the velocity. To do that, we change places of the variables and get velocity equals square root of 2 times gravitational acceleration constant g, which is the y component of gravity property of physics in unity, and times height, which was previously calculated. Using y component and half range vectors, we calculate the velocity for x and z axes in one calculation and store the velocity values in y, x, z vector. Using range equals 2 times initial velocity x times initial velocity y divided with g, gravitational acceleration constant, we change places again and get initial xz velocity equals half range times g divided by initial y velocity. Here too is gone by range equals half range times 2. In 2D, the concepts are explained in x and y, but for 3D calculations of x-axis holds for z-axis as well. That is why we use a vector and apply the calculations to both axes. In other words, it will be totally okay to divide y-x-z vector into two float values and make calculations separately. Also, here are two minus signs that are applied to negate the negative acceleration value on physics engine of Unity. If you do not negate those, we will get negative results or errors on square root calculation. To keep the calculations correct, we multiply the physics gravity with minus 1. Now we calculated all the velocity values needed for 3 axes and give this information to our spawn so that it can start its movement by calling move with velocity and gravity function. By your direction of shooting game objects, x and z axes may need changing places or signs. So if you get unexpected results, please have a check on this. With that, we made a walkthrough of a way to shoot 3D objects to a target position using ballistic trajectory by setting the max height of the trajectory to the distance between the object and target position on the y-axis. In the last couple of videos, I have been applying physics to move objects to a target position or predict the movement trajectory. I hope this will be helpful in your games, and if you have any questions or suggestions or feedback, please let me know in the comments. There are some more topics that I plan to cover for future videos, but I am open for suggestions. If you like this video and want to see similar ones, you can give this one a like and subscribe for the future ones. I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!